Today I would like to present you our recent results related to the assessment of the toxic potential of carbon nanomaterials. In our study, we compared the toxicity of carbon anions, carbon anions, nanodiamonds, and graphene oxide in zebrafish during the development. And these carbon nanomaterials are increasingly employed in different biomedical applications. However, a better understanding of their long-term effect on a vertebrate system is required. We exposed the embryos to different concentrations of carbon anions, carbon anhorns, nanodiamonds, and graphene oxide, and we evaluated the different toxicological endpoints in order to investigate the interaction between the four different materials and zebrafish in terms of toxicity assessment. Here you can see the optical image of the embryos and larvae at the different stage of investigation. We assess the toxicity on six different stages of development, starting from the gastrular stage that you can see here and here, until a completed developed zebrafish, this stage and this stage. And as you can see from the optical imaging, at the 24 hours post-fertilization, the zebrafish is surrounded by a chorion that acts like a protective barrier from the environment. And it possesses pore of above 500 nanometers, allowing the nanomaterial to enter by passive diffusion. The survival rate of carbon anions, carbon anhorns, and nanodiamonds present a behavior concentration dependent, as you can see from the plot. And for instance, at the higher concentration that you can see here, the survival rate of carbon anions, carbon anhorns, and nanodiamonds decrease from 100 to 95, 94, and 92% respectively for the carbon anions, carbon anhorns, and nanodiamonds. On the other hand, the graphene oxide presents a significant decrease in the survival rate between 72 and 120 hours post-fertilization at the higher concentration that are 50 and 100 micrograms on an per ml. In this temporal window, the graphene oxide induces toxicity and the value of the survival rate are under 90%. A similar trend is visible also for the etching rate corresponding to the chorion aperture. In accordance to the normative law, to consider nanomaterial as non-toxic, as you can see from the red line, the survival rate and the etching rate should be more than 90% and 80%. In conclusion, our results report that carbon anions, carbon anhorns, and nanodiamonds present a behavior concentration dependent on zebrafish with no detectable toxicity on this vertebrate system, and on the other hand, graphene oxide, as you can see from the plot, induce a high toxicity with a consequent developmental delay. Also, we evaluated the possible morphological defects induced by the four different nanomaterials. And as you can see from the plot, for the carbon anions, nanohorns, and nanodiamonds, increasing the concentration of the three different carbon nanomaterials, we have an increase in the malformation, reaching a value of 6% in the case of nanodiamonds, violet column for the pericardial edema. This low value indicates the biosafety of the free carbon nanomaterial. On the contrary, graphene oxide induces a high percentage of malformation reaching for the same malformation, same concentration, a percentage of 13. This indicates the toxicity of the nanomaterial. Concluding, we demonstrated the non-toxicity and good biocompatibility of carbon anions, carbon anorns, and nanodiamonds on zebrafish in the different developmental stages that we investigated. And on the other side, the toxicity of the graphene oxide at the higher concentration. Moreover, we proved that the carbon anions present a higher biocompatibility compared to carbon anorns and nanodiamonds. And we can estimate that carbon anions are the most promising carbon nanomaterials for biomedical application. In conclusion, I would like to thank my supervisor, Professor Silvia Giordani, for this project, Dr. Stefania Lettieri and Alberto Casmisasca for the synthesis of carbon anions and the characterization of all the nanomaterials, Professor Olga Sheredova for providing us the nanodiamonds, the construction for giving me the opportunity to present our recent work here, and for sure all of you for your attention. Thanks.